हेलो गाइस, आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग गुड. आई एम वैशाली की कान एंड वी आर डिस्कसिंग द ऑप्टिकल कम्युनिकेशन. टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट द स्कैटरिंग. आई होप यू ऑल हैव वॉच्ड ऑल ऑफ द प्रीवियस वीडियोस ऑन द ऑप्टिकल कम्युनिकेशन. इफ नॉट, इट इज हाईली रिकमेंडेड दैट यू गो बैक, वॉच देम फर्स्ट एंड देन कम टू दिस वीडियो. एंड इफ यू हैव स्टिल नॉट वॉच देम, एट लीस्ट वॉच द प्रीवियस टू वीडियोज ऑन द एब्जॉर्प्शन, मटीरियल एब्जॉर्प्शन एंड द एटीन्यूएशन ऑल्सो. So as of now, I'm considering, you know, what is attenuation, and I'm going to relate the scattering with the attenuation. In the attenuation, I told you scattering is a type of attenuation itself. So today we are going to see what is scattering, how it is going to attenuate the signal, what is linear scattering, how it is going to produce the losses in the optical fiber. And then we are going to talk about the two types of linear scattering, that is the Rayleigh scattering and the Mie scattering. So we are going to see both of them, and then we are going to understand what is the difference between both of them. So this video is going to be really interesting one, and I hope you all are watching this video very carefully. So let's start our discussion with the scattering. So we are starting with a very basic thing. What is scattering? Now we all have studied about this word scattering. We all know that why is the sky looking blue? Right, it is because of the scattering of the light, because of the particles which are present in the atmosphere. So now the light is spreading out. So scattering is related to the spreading out of the light. Now when I am sending the signal or the optical light inside the optical fiber, what will happen? There would be some inhomogeneities present inside the optical fiber, or I can say there are some non-uniformities present inside the optical fiber. Now in the similar manner as I compared with the atmosphere, the non-uniformity which are present inside the optical fiber is going to spread out the light, right? So it is going to change the path of the light, I can say. Now when the path of the light is changed, so you can see if the light is traveling like this, and due to some inhomogeneity light is having this path, right, or this path. So you can see we have changed the incident angle. So you can see here we have changed the incident angle of these two lights. Now when the incident angle is changed, the mode will be changed. We all know this thing. With the ray theory of the light, I told you mode is related to the incident angle, and now when the incident angle is changed, mode can be changed into the leaky modes or the radiated mode also. So when the guided mode is changed into leaky or radiated mode, the power is going to radiate in the atmosphere. Okay, so it is going to cause the attenuation. As the signal is going to the atmosphere, it is leaking from the optical fiber, it is going to attenuate the signal, right? So this is undesirable. Okay, so now here we have the mode transfer. We all have understood why we have the mode transfer, due to the non-uniformities that are present in the glass fiber. So the mode transfer would be there, is resulting into the leaky mode or the radiation mode. Both of them are going to cause the optical power loss into the form of radiation of the optical fiber out from the fiber. Okay, so the power is going away from the fiber, and this is how our signal is getting attenuated. So now glass, the optical fiber is made up of glass. Glass is composed of randomly connected network of the molecules. So now when it has the randomly connected network of the molecules, it is going to increase the compositional fluctuations. So when it is having higher compositional fluctuations, it is going to give more scattering, right? So if I talk about the single mode or the multimode fiber, if I compare both of them, in the multimode fiber I will be having more doping concentration, right? I will be having more compositional fluctuation, and in comparison to the single mode fiber, in the multimode fiber I will be having more scattering. So this comparison you can remember, right? So now coming to the linear scattering. So what is linear scattering? Linear scattering is a scattering in which there is no change in the frequency. This is a very important term that you can remember, right? So we are going to talk about the two types of linear scattering, that is the Rayleigh scattering and the Mie scattering. So in the Rayleigh scattering, like I told you that we have the light from the sun which is getting scattered, and when it is coming to the atmosphere, our sky is looking blue because it is scattering in all of the directions. So it is a type of Rayleigh scattering. So Rayleigh scattering is happening uniformly in all directions. But on the other hand, Mie scattering is happening in the forward direction only, right? So what does it mean? Now if I have the light which is traveling like this, after scattering it will be having the spreading like this, equal spreading in all directions. So now here this is the light, in the forward direction only it will spread. So it will spread like this, right? So it is going to spread in the front direction only, okay? So there would be no backward scattering in the case of Mie scattering. Now coming to the composition. So inhomogeneity is occurring here on the small scale as compared to the wavelength. So whatever wavelength of light that I am sending through the optical fiber, the inhomogeneities are very small as compared to the wavelength, and then only Rayleigh scattering will occur. Similarly, in the atmosphere, the particles are very small as compared to the wavelength of the light that is coming into the atmosphere, and this is the reason we are having the scattering of the light due to the Rayleigh scattering. Okay, so here you can see we have the inhomogeneities which are on a very small scale as compared to the wavelength. On the other hand, in the Mie scattering, I have the hologenetic condition, which means the inhomogeneities are comparable to the wavelength of the light which I am using as the guided wavelength, right? So inhomogeneities are comparable to the guided wavelength. So now here in the intrinsic loss mechanism, we will be having absorption window which is coming from the infrared to the UV only. So we will be having very narrow absorption window, and we have to avoid using this window. Right, so in this window I cannot operate, right? So intrinsic loss mechanism in low absorption window is between infrared to UV. I will be having inhomogeneities which are present due to two reasons. First is the refractive index variation, which I cannot control, right? So if the refractive index variation are there during the fabrication time, I cannot control it later on. So during the fabrication time only, I have to compensate for it. I have to get a fabrication method in which I will be having less refractive index variation. And the second parameter is the compositional variation. As I told you, increased compositional fluctuation is giving me increased scattering. So compositional variations should be reduced, because if it is high, it is going to give me higher scattering. It is reduced by improving the fabrication method. Now how do we reduce the Mie scattering? We have the Mie scattering which is present due to the non-perfect cylindrical structure of the waveguide. If the cylindrical structure is non-perfect, you can see if the cylindrical structure is like this, so it is a non-perfect cylindrical structure. In that case, the Mie scattering would be evident. It will be due to the fiber imperfections, due to the core cladding irregularities, right? So when I'm coating the layer of the cladding over the core, there would be some irregularities at the interface. So you can see this is my core, and here at the cladding core interface I will be having some irregularities, and due to which Mie scattering will be happening. Due to the core cladding refractive index differences, and it will be happening along the fiber length. So I can change the refractive index with the help of proper fabrication method only, right? So I have to take proper consideration about the refractive index variation, how my refractive index is varying from core to cladding. Now after that, diameter fluctuations. Okay, so here you can see if I have a higher diameter, lower diameter and higher diameter. this is type of optical fiber that we have, then I will be having higher mean scattering. Then I will be having some strains, or we will be having some bubbles inside the optical fiber, then there would be the higher possibility of the mean scattering. Now, here in the Rayleigh scattering, it is proportional to the 1 upon lambda raised to power 4. If I increase the lambda, if I increase the wavelength, Rayleigh scattering is going to decrease. You can see it is inversely proportional to lambda raised to power 4. So, how I can reduce the Rayleigh scattering? I can increase the operational wavelength. Okay, so this is the relation for the Rayleigh scattering coefficient. So, Rayleigh scattering coefficient will be equal to 8 pi cube upon 3 lambda 4. You can see here it is inversely related to the lambda raised to power 4, n raised to power 8, p raised to power 2, beta c k tf. Now, what are all these things? We know pi, we know 8, we know 3. All these things are constant. We know lambda. Lambda is the operational wavelength. Now, what is n? N is the refractive index. So, what is beta c? Beta c is the isothermal compressibility at some fictive temperature tf. So, tf is the fictive temperature. I am going to talk about the fictive temperature also. So, what is k? K is the Boltzmann constant. Okay, so I hope you understood the gamma r here would be Rayleigh scattering coefficient. So, now what is fictive temperature? Fictive temperature is the equilibrium temperature. So, the temperature at which the glass can reach a state of equilibrium, and it is related to the annealing temperature as well. Right? So, we all have understood what is annealing. Annealing is the term which is associated with the uniformity of the atomic structure. So, when the atoms are at a random manner inside the optical fiber, I am going to give it some high temperature. At some high temperature, these atoms will rearrange and they will be coming to the uniform structure. So, now when I have the uniform structure at a higher temperature, this temperature is the annealing temperature. So, I hope you understood what is the fictive temperature. So, now the transmission loss factor or the transmittivity for the Rayleigh scattering. So, what is the transmission loss factor or the transmittivity? It is denoted by this symbol and it is given as gamma r into l, where l is the length of the fiber. Okay, so gamma r is the Rayleigh scattering coefficient. So, when I multiplied the Rayleigh scattering coefficient with the length of the optical fiber, I am going to get the transmittivity. Okay, so it can be reduced, or the Rayleigh scattering can be reduced by operating at the longest possible wavelength. We have understood it from this relation. Right? I hope you understood it. So, now here in the mean scattering, the inhomogeneity size should be greater than lambda by 10. When the inhomogeneity size is greater than lambda by 10, then the angular dependence of the scattering intensity will become very large. And now, I don't want that, so I can reduce the inhomogeneity size. Okay, so it depends upon the fiber material design as well as the manufacture. How I have manufactured the given optical fiber? What is the material that I have used? What is the design of the given optical fiber? Right, so we can reduce the inhomogeneities by removing the imperfection due to the glass manufacturing process. I can use an improved manufacturing process where I can get the lesser number of inhomogeneities. I can carefully control the extrusion and the coating of the fiber so that the cladding would be very perfectly placed on the core and there would be less irregularities which are present in the core cladding interface. So, we have to perfectly coat the cladding onto the core. Then we can increase the fiber guidance by increasing the relative refractive index. Right? I can increase the difference between N1 and N2. N1 is the refractive index of the core and N2 is the refractive index of the cladding. And in this manner, I can increase the guidance. So, here I hope you understood what is scattering, what is linear scattering, what is Rayleigh scattering, what is mean scattering, what are the difference between both of them. If you have still any kind of doubt, you can put the doubt in the comment and I will be trying to resolve your doubt as soon as possible. I hope you like this session. If you like it, please push the like button, subscribe to the channel. Meet me soon in the next video. Okay, so stay tuned for the next video. Share it with your friends as well. Thank you so much.